In regards to reducing waste and reuse, I can't think of a better way to maximize a kind of a recycle kind of concept than to use an existing building.
The decision about looking specifically at an existing building came about really because of that desire to show what could be done in an existing building.
So one of the beliefs on designing a zero net energy building is that you have to start from scratch.
I've been a mechanical contractor for 26 years and all our work is done in the desert climate in Phoenix. So I thought, can we really achieve what we're trying to achieve and what the vision of DPR was ultimately for the building?
It was expected from everyone that 1970s glazing could not meet the high requirements of a zero net energy building.
It's a myth that reuse and LEED and green are going to cost you money in every circumstance. In circumstances like this, they saved us a lot of money.
Because we didn't have windows and we had existing facades, we utilized those in our project and we redesigned the interior to match what we had as an existing limitation. We thought was a limitation at the start, but it ended up being an advantage to the project.
If you do it right, you repurpose materials and repurpose utilization of the building, there's some savings as well.
The fact is, you know, we worked around that and we modeled it and we changed our building design so that we could use that glazing in our building. We not only saved the materials, it also saved, I believe, $300,000 that we were able to use in other sustainable features. This money had already been budgeted to replace the glazing.
We can build one of these projects, we can do it with an existing physical building, repurpose it and reuse it, and make it renewable and energy efficient.
And so, you know, when you're working with an existing building, you're able to take what may be limitations and make them into opportunities. And that's something that doesn't occur in new construction.
So the idea that you could take an old retail building that doesn't really seem to have much kind of architectural value, or someone might perceive its worth as not being that valuable, and turning it into something like this is a tremendous demonstration of how you can use old things and make them new again.